dreams.
Hunga kihi kihi. Long distance call for you, Mr. Black Quail.
Hunga kihi kihi. Yes, this is Black Quail.
Go ahead, St. Petersburg.
Mr. Black Quail, I've just found it, sir.
Well, are you sure it wasn't just another yellow bird again, Smith?
Yes, sir. It definitely is a 1935 Martin M-130 flying boat.
Will it fly?
That's the problem, sir.
Anyway, I don't care what it takes. It's for the honor of PHA. Do it.
Yes, sir, Mr. Blackwell.
Finally, I've got it. My dream is coming true.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the most fantastic video graphics world, a world that is the hope of 2 million MSX computer fans, the fabulous, the wonderful, the one and only Ecosphere, the flying Luna Clipper.
Grand Holose Airways has been attracting a lot of attention these days with a fantastic new idea.
Aloha, this is Gail with Channel 7. Our next feature is Honolulu Voices. Today we have big news for you. Pan Holose Airways has been attracting a lot of attention these days with a fantastic new idea. The plan was hatched after many years of planning and dreaming by the president, Con Blackwell. This dream is to revive the romantic flights of the good old days of aviation. They now have one of only three Martin M130 China Clippers, built in 1935, and none were thought to still be in existence. Mr. Blackwell said this flying boat is now being restored to flying condition by PHA. He has named it the Luna Clipper, the fantastic flying Dreamworld Theater. The Luna Clipper will fly to Papeete, Tahiti from Honolulu at night. The plane is equipped with a 200-inch wide TV screen and other entertainment facilities. The only requirement for prospective passengers is that they must believe they are the greatest dreamers. Anyone with a fantastic dream can make an application to PHA, and only time will tell if this idea will ever fly. And now for the world weather forecast. First, from Asia, Tokyo will be a little bit cool tomorrow. Beijing will have isolated rain showers, beautiful red leaves in Paris, and in Vienna, a nice day is expected. Please enjoy the sun. Still very hot for Africans. You'll never be cool in Casablanca. Autumn in New York will see shimmering clouds, and you can see the beautiful aurora in Nome, Alaska. Finally, Honolulu will be mostly dreamy tomorrow night. This week's 7-day forecast is for the Palau Islands. On the 5th, thunderstorms. From 6th to 8th, there will be occasional rain showers. From the 9th, it will be fair and fantastic. Now, stay tuned for the Hulu TV feature. Now, please enjoy the Hula TV.
Greatest dreamer.
Turn it by my side.
That's alright.
How you doing? Hello, say.
It's not hello, say. Jose. Jose. You got that? Did you dream well last night, huh? Gosh.
Gonna be fine, hello, say.
Jose. Jose.
Has another hit. Lulu Clipper goods are a great success. Everywhere, Amiibo shops, colorful Lunar Clipper badges, fashionable printed t-shirts, and beautiful color posters of the Lunar Clipper are already sold out. Honolulu is really hopping with the Lunar Clipper boom. This boom has resulted in a variety of goods, like Luna Slippers. Makes you want to try it, doesn't it?
Hey, you guys. Oh, sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Are these the great dream guests?
Hi.
Welcome aboard.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to have you aboard this maiden flight of Pan Halose Airways Luna Clipper. My name is Grace. I'll be your chief attendant for the flight. I'd like to demonstrate for you some of the safety features of the Luna Clipper. As you can see, oxygen masks will drop down from above you in the unlikely case of an emergency. Please pull the mask strap over your head like this and breathe normally. To inflate your life jacket, simply pull this ring and it will inflate. Just kidding. If you pull down the table in front of you... Gosh, not like that. You can choose the video graphic channel you want with a push of the button.
I said hi every night. You said peace, salary. I saw the earth in my hand. I can stop for love. Take your time, that's alright. I get the sunshine.
If you feel young and want to play, we have the newest hit video game, Hunga Kiki. Please sit back and relax and enjoy it.
Oh my God.
Entertainment, but we'd like to introduce ourselves. This is Captain E.
As you see, in this massive Pacific Ocean, countless islands are spread out over many miles. But these islands used to be uninhabited. I'm going to talk about ancient Polynesians who had voyaged over the Pacific Ocean using double canoes. Look at this map. 1,500 years ago, Raiatea Island used to be called Hawaii, just west of Tahiti, where we're heading. From Raiatea Island, brown-skinned, brave men and women went fearlessly through the wild sea waves. They were the descendants of the mightiest god of the sea, Tongariro. They were truly great voyagers. After their departure, when they had been gone for 3 weeks,
Tongariro.
Do you regret taking this journey?
Why should we regret it? I had a fortunate vision from heaven before we set sail 3 weeks ago, on a crescent moonlit night. A beautiful yellow bird appeared. It was leading us to a beautiful island. We decided to entrust our destiny to the yellow bird because of the famine. We are your children. Although we had loved the island where we were born, we dared to leave there. Please grant us the power.
The power must come from within yourself.
Storm when they came to, they knew that one of the canoes had been lost forever in the storm. They repaired the torn sails and tightened the lashings. They persevered. They were rowing out on the equatorial, windless sea. The crescent moon has appeared to us again. They knew that they were in a different sea by the smell and the taste. Then...
Look at that!
The yellow bird from the dream was really there, flying gracefully in the air.
Oh,
look at that!
Owie! Owie! Owie!
finally reached the unknown island and named it Hawaii, after Hawaii, where they'd lived. A story of 1,300 years ago. Later, man's migration would not end, and now he has been on the moon. It is said that NASA in the United States named the spacecraft Voyager in honor of these great Polynesian voyagers.
Great voyagers.
That holos, isn't it, Coco?
Yeah, it's holo, say, all right.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am an authority on oceanography, Professor Derek. No relation to the professional baseball player, Mr. Derek Dragon. How's the weather up there? I've never been up there. Anyway, I am a specialist in the field of oceanography, so let me talk about the mystery of Hirose a little bit. I have been investigating the Hirose mystery all around this massive Pacific Ocean for more than 2,000 years. What's Hirose? It's what Mr. Coco has on his nose. Don't bother me. Because I'm an expert on the subject of oceanography, I found many kinds of Hirose in Polynesia, Melanesia, Micronesia. Think about it. What does Hirose mean? Have you ever heard about the lost continent called Mu in the Pacific Ocean? Beautiful. But in my opinion, unlike Mr. Churchbard, it was always been clear that such a continent was only the product of man's imagination because of the plate tectonics theory. Although Mu never existed, it is my belief that there have been a Mu culture sphere in the Pacific Ocean area, and also people in the island surely use Hirose as the symbol of the four creative powers. As you saw, the influence of Hirose has been spread by the great voyagers 1,500 years ago. Just between you and me, Captain Iko is from Kochi Prefecture, which is located on Japan's Pacific coast. In Kochi, when a person is bitten by a mosquito, he marks the spot with a cross-like symbol using his fingernail. This nail cross point is also referred to as Hirose. What you see next will help you understand the significance of Hirose because I have devoted my life to the study of oceanography.
I am the sun, Let me introduce my family. This is Mercury.
Hi there, I'm Mercury.
Venus.
Hello, everyone. I'm Venus.
And this is Earth.
We're your wings, Panhalosa Airways. The Luna Clipper Dream of PHA has just crossed the equator now. In honor of this occasion, Holosa badges will be given to everyone.
Where are you from, Mr. Yukio?
I'm from Nome, in Alaska.
Nice hat.
Thank you. What? Wow!
Hey, right on!
And now a message from Captain Eco. Don't fasten your seatbelt. Please release your... What? Not that belt, Mr. Bebo. Please!
Next, we have an incredibly interesting video graphic that Captain Eco did in 1986. Gravity Dance.
Everybody is falling.
What a strange monkey the human race is.
What an impressive moment.
Bonsoir, monsieur et mademoiselle de Coachzone. Welcome to this Polynesian show in Parabola. Please enjoy yourselves. You see, I'm Napoleon. Okay, Polynesian breed!
Happy birthday! Happy birthday! It's so stiff these days.
What? Oh. Is this... What? Is this a dream? No!
だね。
mister. We're gonna fly now.
Begin our descent for arrival in Papeete, Tahiti. On your right, Morea Island, shining in a beautiful shade of orange.
Wow, it was like a dream.
It was really a great trip.
What a trip. Oh, great time. I can't believe how great it was. Incredible.
Does he know where he's going? Oh, well, that's okay. I think.
That morning, they say it was snowing in the southern islands.